I say I shoot them, Dad? I prefer to shoot them.
Yeah, my order for you, Dad, shoot to kill them. Wala po kialam dyan sa iyo, mga niliwala. I don't give a shit kung anong gusto nilang sabihin. I killed about 3 of them because of 3 of them. I didn't really know how many bullets from my gun went through inside their bodies, but it happened.
I say I shoot them, Dad. I prefer to shoot them in the heart or in the head. If you insist on a drug war, I will kill you.
Walong bisis siya pumatay ng tao, tagang parang masaya siya basta may namamatay na tao. Yan ang habit niya.
Kasi yung pinatay ko, medyo nag-ano rin yun eh. May galit rin yun sila sa akin.
Ang nasamahan ko dyan yung sa pagkapatay, paglilibing, siguro mga 300 plus katao yung nalibing ko.
Until the last pusher is out of the streets. Until the last drug lord is killed. Talagang papatayin kita.
The whole Davao Death Squad network was used as Mayor Rodrigo Roa Duterte's personal killing machine.
Kakinurap mo yan kung sinong sunduin kita ng helicopter papuntang Manila, itatapon kita sila.
They took advantage of our blind loyalty to him in our greed for money to promote and protect his personal and political interests.
I will assume full legal responsibility. Ayan ang human rights. Ako ang mangharap niyan, hindi naman kayo.
All of our targets were killed based solely on the intel information and orders given by Mayor Rodrigo Roa Duterte himself.
Ang kasalanan ko lang, yung mga extrajudicial killing.
It's not a dog, my son. It's not a dog or a pig to kill like them.
Siya ang pinaka-protector ng mga drug lord dito sa Pilipinas. Basic example niyan is si Michael Yang at si Adan Lim.
Sinasabi ko, I can clean it in 6 months. And after that, I realized na nagkamali talaga ako.
Kaya siya ang pinaka-lord of all the drug lords.
Okay, sige po. Salamat. So, we will now proceed with the next agenda. May we recognize Congressman Akop, our Vice Chair, to please discuss the ground rules for today's committee hearing. You are recognized, Congressman Akop.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I would just like to repeat the rules applicable insofar as our hearing is concerned. Only the microphone of the lead chairperson or presiding officer shall be on unmute mode at the start of the meeting. During the period of interpellation, resource persons shall be given 5 minutes each to state their position or make a presentation in the meeting. Resource persons shall not be allowed to speak or make interjections unless and until they are recognized by the lead chairperson or the presiding officer. Committee members and other House members who want to make statements or ask questions to resource persons shall register with the committee secretary of the lead committee and shall be recognized by the lead chairperson or the presiding officer on a first to register basis. Members shall be given 10 minutes each for their interpellation, excluding the answers of the resource persons. No member except the lead chairperson or the presiding officer shall be allowed to speak or make interjections during the course of the interpellation of a member unless and until recognized by the lead chairperson or the presiding officer. Any question addressed to the joint committee shall be presented to the committees separately, and the decision of the joint committee shall be the majority vote of the four committees. Now, insofar as the role of councils is concerned, the councils, Mr. Chair, should see to it that they should present their appearance to the Quad Committee if there are councils present, and the participation of counsel for the witness during the hearing and while the witness is testifying shall only be limited to advising on the legal rights of the said witness or resource person. Counsel for a witness or resource person shall conduct oneself in a professional manner and shall observe proper decorum. Otherwise, upon a majority vote of the members present, there being a quorum, such counsel shall be subject to contempt or to such other disciplinary action that may include censure and removal from the room where the hearing.
May kailangan ka bang bilhin pero wala kang pera? Gamitin mo ang Chip Peso.
Borrow up.
The next part of the agenda is the discussion or deliberation on how we give the first crack of asking questions is from the member of the minority, Congressman Arlinda.
Mahigit 200 ang kasama ko sa baba. Lahat sila may kwento. Lahat sila nawalan. At ang nawala sa kanya ay ang mga taong bumubuhay sa kanila. Katulad doon na sabi ko sa Quadcom, bago ko ibigay yung microphone sa mga kasamahan kong naririto sa pangungunan ni Randy De Los Santos na siyang kumakatawan sa program Panghilom at susunod magsasalita. Sabi ko sa Senado, kung mayroong sistema ang pinagmamalaki, kung mayroong baril na ginamit ang mga nanlaban at tunay na nanlaban sila, then Mr. Chair, let it be. Let it happen today. Let it happen in this Quadcom. Let us call the directors of operations and ask ilang baril ang naroon sa kasalukuyan.
Then, ito guys, Quadcom hearing natuloy dahil dumating si ex-president Duterte. Ayun, comment reaction tayo dito, and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.